This is a very basic chapter which we have already studied in the previous standards. Here is Yashi Vadera, and today we are going to learn active and passive voice. So the first question arises that what is voice? So the voice of a verb indicates whether its subject is the doer or the receiver of the action. Suppose we take two examples. First one, John cooked the food last night, and the second one, the food was cooked by John last night. Both the sentences express the same meaning, but in sentence one, the subject John is the doer of the action, so the verb cooked is said to be in active voice. So a verb is in the active voice when its form shows the person or thing denoted by the subject does something. So in other words, we can say that the subject is the doer of the action. But in sentence 2, the subject, the food, is the receiver of the action, and so the verb was cooked is said to be in passive voice. So a verb is in the passive voice when its form shows that something is done to the person or thing denoted by the subject. Again, the question arises, what is the use of this passive voice? Why should we use passive voice? So the answer is here, the active voice is more commonly used than the passive voice because it is direct and forceful. The passive voice may be used for the following reasons. First, to eliminate the mention of the agent. For example, Ravi was found stealing. Second, to lay emphasis on the recipient of the action. English is spoken all over the world. Here is the example. Third, to make an impersonal statement. For example, it is hoped that the situation will improve. Now let us learn some important conversion from active voice to passive voice, or we can say some important rules. First, if a transitive verb has two objects, it may become the subject in the passive voice. For example, in active voice, Mary taught Ravi French. In passive, we can convert it to the both. Ravi was taught French by Mary, or French was taught to Ravi by Mary. Second, when a prepositional verb is changed from active to passive voice, the preposition should not be dropped. Active voice example, they laughed at the joker. Passive, the joker was laughed at by them. Third point, to change auxiliary verbs from active to passive voice, add be along with the past participle to the verb. For example, in active voice, Ram can do the work, and in passive, the work can be done by Ram. Fourth point, to change imperative sentences from active to passive voice, let be is used if the sentence is to remain imperative, otherwise should be is used. For example, open the door. In passive, let the door be opened, or the door should be opened. Fifth point, if the intransitive verbs are used, the change of imperative sentences into passive voice is carried out in the following manner. Suppose in active voice, sit down. In passive, you are ordered to sit down. Here is the sixth point. Sometimes a transitive verb is not changed to passive form but given the passive sense. For example, active, sugar tastes sweet. So in passive, we can convert as sugar is sweet when it is tasted. Now let's remember the voice according to our tenses. Tenses plays the most important role to understand this chapter. The first tense is simple present tense. Below is the formula of active voice, subject plus first form of the verb plus object plus other words. Passive, object plus MSR plus third form of the verb plus by plus subject plus other words. For example, we celebrate Holi with enthusiasm. We is subject, celebrate is first form of the verb, holy is the object and with enthusiasm is other word. As per above formula, the given sentence is in active voice and is in simple present tense. Now to convert it into the passive voice, just change the positions of subject and object as shown below. Holi is celebrated by us with enthusiasm. Convert this according to the formula. Holi is object plus amizar plus V3 plus by plus subject plus OW. If the given active voice is interrogative, it can also be converted very easily. For example, do the people honor their parents? Just change the do or does to am, is or are and solve above active voice or sentence according to formula. Am, is or are is taken according to the object. For example, passive. So, are their parents honored by the people? Here object, verb 3 and subject remains according to formula. Second tense is simple past tense. Here is the formula. Active voice, subject plus second form of the verb plus object plus other words. In passive, object plus was verb plus V3 plus by plus subject plus other words. Example, my own friend betrayed me. My own friend subject betrayed second form of verb me object. So here the object me comes forward and becomes the subject. I was betrayed third form of the verb by my own friend. And my own friend become object here. Again, if interrogative is there, it can be solved very easily. Did his polite words hurt you? Just change did to was or were and solve above active sentence. Again, was or were is taken according to the objects. For example, did his impolite words hurt you? In the passive voice, just change did. It will be, were you hurt by his impolite words? Now let us understand the third tense, simple future tense. Given is the formula, active voice, subject plus will or shall plus first form of the verb plus object plus other word. In passive, object plus will shall plus BEB plus V3 plus by plus subject plus OW. Example, I will open this knot. So simple, take the object forward. This knot will be opened by me. And in the interrogative ones, again simple, will they organize a dance? Will or shall do not change its position and it will be taken according to the object. So will a dance be organized by them?